Next month, we had, and Julie is coming to our 19th annual Summer Song Songwriting Camp. Elizabeth, and you guys have been there before, Chuck. And it's a beautiful camp where people of all ages, shapes, and sizes, mostly baby boomers like us, come to rekindle their connection to the music that they played when they were younger and somehow got distracted away from. So would you say it was a positive experience?
Absolutely.
Yeah. And Julie's been really, really a lot of fun. And we have our 19th annual coming up in Stony Point, New York, just north and west of New York City. Yeah, Stony Point Center. Yeah, really, really fun. So this started in 1999, and 2 years later, 2001, I've been in every single one. In 2001, a fine Irish fellow from Philadelphia showed up at camp, named Tom Ryan. And Tom and I became friends immediately because we found out we had a lot in common. We love a love of music and songwriting, a love of a sense of humor, a love of sports, and a love of singing and talking about what's going on in the world in a respectful and heartful way, you know, so that no one feels pushed farther away than they already are, but rather are invited to dialogue. That's my thing. So Tom and I became friends, and Tom's day job was Sparkles the Clown.
Oh my gosh.
You know, there are professional clowns out there. He was one.
I don't like clowns.
Well, we'll get into that later, but may I continue?
Yes.
So Sparkles, that was his day job, and he would go to nursing homes, hospitals, you know, schools, libraries, you name it, sprinkling a little magic happiness here and there. He's one of the good clowns. And as we became friends, and whenever I would play in the Philadelphia area, Tom would show up, and he would be coming right from a clown gig. So he would call me up and say, hey Dave, I'd like to just drop by and say hi, but I'm coming right from a clown gig. I won't have time to change. I said, no problem. So at any point in time, you know, at any number of concert halls or coffee houses or conference centers, I would see the big, puffy white hand waving. And Sparkles had a ribbon. My favorite time was at Pendle Hill Quaker Conference Center, where I was leading teaching a week-long course called Writing Songs for Personal and Global Change. And I had a full class for a whole week, and I decided to throw an open mic in the Quaker Meeting Hall. Anybody ever been in one? All the pews are faced in a square towards the middle. Uh-huh. And it's a big open space. And so I had all my students on the inner square, and the community came out and filled up all the pews and behind all of us. And it was a great night. And Tom Sparkles called me and said, hey, can I drop by? I'm coming right from behind. Absolutely. So in the middle of this, you know, Quaker Meeting Hall, in walks Sparkles, there's the big puffy hand, and I saved a spot for him. So he walked in and people were going, I didn't explain a thing. And when the guitar came to Sparkles, he picked up a guitar and he played one of his songs. Here's a couple of examples of the kind of songs Tom Ryan wrote. The Barn's Burnt Down. Now I Can See the Moon. How Many Points for My Son? Talking about desensitization in our kids, about violence from video games, you know, and actual war, where our youngsters are shooting one another. Beautiful songwriter. Everything I love in songwriting. So we became good friends, and Tom would come to camp every year for 10 years. So now it's 2011, the 10th anniversary of our meeting, and we had done other things as friends would do. And Tom showed up at camp in 2011, age 59, looking about 150. Because he had a recent and aggressive cancer diagnosis. He looked like hell. But his eyes were still shining as only Sparkles on his coat. And he got himself to camp. He had a couple friends help him. And he didn't look good at all. And he didn't come to have a goodbye or a pity party. He just wanted to write more songs with his friends. That's what he loved to do. So Tom and I were sitting in the cafeteria one day. Tom said, Dave, it's great to be here. I said, you don't know how good it is to have you here, Tom. How long have we known each other now? He said, 10 years. You feel like a brother to me. He said, yeah, you do too. And he had plenty of siblings, but he was the kind of guy who could feel like your brother. And yeah, you feel like a brother to me too. I said, so we've known each other 10 years? He said, yeah. I said, in all this time, have we ever written a song together? No. I said, let's make that a priority this week while we're together. Let's do that. Great. We're sitting in the cafeteria. I said, I got to go talk to somebody, but I'll be back in an hour. Let's meet right here in the lunchroom. Tom Ryan, fine Irishman from Philadelphia, said, I'll keep the table set. That's where that song comes from that I just sang. That's what we wrote that day.
Wow.
podcast because Tom passed away the next year, in September of 2012. He had arranged all the songs for his memorial service. He invited me to sing one of mine, which I did, Mame Singing at the End of the Night. And he had arranged for a circle of chairs in his sister's driveway in Westchester, Pennsylvania, to be so we could have a song circle after the memorial service with one chair for Tom, and we sang for 3 hours, you know, taking turns in his sister's driveway. So I tell you that story at the beginning, towards the beginning of the evening, especially for you new people, just to let you know who are the building blocks of my inspiration. People like Tom have inspired me, and you know, it is from people like this, not from people I'm hearing, you know, blasted in the news and the media, all this, you know, people like beautiful people like Tom, because he reminds me there are many, many more beautiful, good-hearted people in the world than we're being told are, or, you know, there's ways to connect. So that's where Keep the Table Set comes from. So Tom Ryan, and you'll also maybe hear a little Peter, Paul, and Mary Lee tonight, or Simon Garfunkel, or Gordon Lightfoot, or Joan Baez, or Joni Mitchell, or Alan Sherman, or Tom Muir. I'm not doing their songs, but you'll hear the influences. You know, hear the influences. It's not a comprehensive list. Gordon Lightfoot, Tom Paxton, you know, Phil Ux, Pete Seeger, Woody Guthrie, Joan Baez, Joni Mitchell, you know, Carole King, James Taylor, Steve Goodman, John Prine, Michael Smith, Ann Hills, you know, all of them. So these are the kind of people who would infect my songs. And I couldn't be more lucky than to have either heard their music, Jackson Browne, or known them and worked with them a little bit. Time for a love song. Actually, this is the title song of my first cylinder. Or was it an 8-track?
Rising in love,
rising alarm. I am rising.